Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of Python, that is this 3.9.5, in your Windows 10 operating system. So, let's begin. Now, before installing Python, let us first check whether Python has already been installed on your computer or not. So for that, just simply go to your command prompt and in here, just simply type Python and then enter. And then you'll be seeing this Python is not recognized as an internal or an external command. So all this means is Python is not installed on your machine. So for that, we need to first install Python. So let us first cancel my command prompt and then just simply go to your favorite browser, and in here if you just simply type Python download, then enter, and then you'll be seeing this www.python.org is basically our first search result. So just simply click on this download Python. This will automatically going to redirect you to this Python.org official website, and in here you can clearly see that this Python 3.9.5 is basically our latest version. So it is very important to upgrade your Python. If you are using some older version, then it is very important to upgrade this latest version. So to download Python 3.9.5, just simply click on this download Python 3.9.5. This will automatically going to start downloading Python. I have already downloaded it, so just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this Python 3.9.5 has been rightly downloaded over here. And you can clearly see that this file size is only 27.0 MB. To install Python, just simply double click on it, and then I am just simply going to minimize my download directory. And in here you can clearly see that this Python 3.9.5 installer wizard has been rightly opened. And now it is very important, guys, you need to check this add Python 3.92 path. This is very important. You need to check this so that the path has automatically going to register in your environment variable. Otherwise, you need to set that path manually. That is a bit challenging. So it is very important, guys, to check this add Python 3.92 path. Alright, now after checking this, you need to search, simply click on this custom installation. And now you can clearly see under this optional features, these are the files that you're going to be installed. That is this documentation, then pip, then this idle, and then this Python test shoot, and then py launcher, and finally, for all users. So, check all this and, simply click on next. And now under this advanced option, you can clearly see that this is going to be your installation destination. I will be recommending you to check this install for all users, so that this installation destination is bit user friendly, and simply keep this all other default, and then just simply click on install. Now after giving administrative privileges, we will be seeing this Python 3.9.5 setup is now currently installing. It will take a couple of minutes, so for which I'll be coming back after installing Python. Yeah. So welcome back. And now as you can see, our Python 3.9.5 has been rightly installed. So you can clearly see that the setup was successful. So just simply click on close. And now if you just simply go to your command prompt and in here just simply type Python, then enter, you can clearly see that Python 3.9.5 has been rightly installed on your machine. So now that you know your Python has been rightly installed and your Python shell has also been opened, so you can do just simple operations like, let's say, 5 plus 3 plus 5, so 8, and 3 into 8 24. So you can do all these simple operations. You can also print hello world in your console. So just print hello world, then enter, and you can clearly see that hello world rightly shown in your console. Now let us first close this command prompt, and if you just simply go to your search, click on this search button and just simply type idle, you can clearly see this idle 3.9 64 bit. So you just simply click on that. So Python also give this this idle shell. So in here you can do that similar type of operation that you are just doing in that command prompt. So 5 plus 3, 8, and you can do this print hello world stuff also to, you know, check whether Python has been, you know, rightly installed or not. So you can clearly see that hello world, you know, currently shown in our console. So you here also you can create a new file. So for that, you know, just simply go to this file, then, you know, new file. This will, you know, automatically going to open untitled file. In here, if you do just, you know, simple program, let's say, let's assign, you know, 5 to variable A, then, you know, assign 3 to variable B. And if you do just, you know, this simple operation, and let's say A into B, and you are just, you know, simply saving that to variable C. And if you just, you know, simply going to print C over here, so you can also over here, then, you know, you're going to go to file, then, you know, click on the save as. So just, you know, simply first go to document, then here create a Python, create a Python workspace. So this is where, you know, your all Python related file is going to be, you know, save this Python workspace. So, and now if you just, you know, simply save this to hello.py, and then, you know, simply click on save. So you can clearly see that your program has been rightly saved under this hello.py. To run, just, you know, simply click on this run button and then run module. You can also press F5 to run, and now you can clearly see 15, that is this, you know, 3 into 5, 15, you are basically doing this 3 into A into B over here. So this 3 into 5, that is 15, is, you know, rightly shown in our console. So in this way, you install Python in your Windows 10 operating system. I have also shown you how to create a simple Python program, and also I have shown you how to run them. So in this way, you install Python in your Windows 10 operating system. The best IDE for Python related project is definitely PyCharm IDE. So I have already made a video on how to install the latest version of PyCharm, that is this 2021 edition, in your Windows 10 operating system. I'll be also putting the link in the description. So here is a preview of that PyCharm. So it is always recommended to use a IDE for, you know, Python related project. So do install Python. So the link will be in the description on how to install PyCharm. I have this website called geekyscript.com. So in here you'll be seeing various tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. So do also check our website geekyscript.com. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and also do share with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.